All right, there were 19 competitors in this year's 212 competition. We're going to get a look at the top 10 here in the early going as Ahmad Ashkenani is announced. Ahmad Ashkenani, of course, from Kuwait, last year's runner-up. Sean Ray joins me to call the action as we learn who will win this year's top prize in the 212-pound division. And Sean, we're getting a look at Ahmad Ashkenani, who last night showed up in what we felt was not quite the condition he was in a year ago. Still very impressive nonetheless.
It's tough. It's not like he's coming from around the corner. He travels miles to get here and was carrying a little bit of water, dried up a little bit. Still needs a little bit more in the quads, but he's got a very nice, complete, compact package of muscle that garnered the Arnold Classic 212 title and posed a threat to all these competitors here.
Well, this division has become increasingly popular over the years. In fact, there was as much talk about Flex Lewis going for 7 as there was Phil Heath going for 8 coming into this competition. Some felt Flex Lewis was actually more vulnerable than Phil Heath, and I guess that's up for debate depending on how you see it. But Ahmad Ashkenani is a big reason why Flex Lewis has his work cut out for him as this contest goes.
They all take turns pushing each other, and with that back width, you can see why Flex Lewis drives harder and harder every year to try to hang on to that title, while guys like Ahmad Ashkenani will remain in the absence of Flex Lewis as he has already announced his retirement from this 212 division. Can't help but wonder if Ahmad Ashkenani's not buying his time and licking his chops and maybe pacing himself, Dan, knowing that he doesn't have to beat James to one day be Olympia champion. James will take care of James, Flex Lewis, and Ahmad. He'll deal with the best of what's left. Very complete.
Ahmad Ashkenani. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome from Libya, Kamal Elghani.
Now this guy, I really like, Dan.
Yeah, one of the stories of the weekend. Just displaying a remarkable level of condition, a remarkable physique, really just great lines, great overall flow and symmetry. Very much what this division was created for. And this is one of the guys who's going to be in the final call out as these guys are taking through their final turns once they get through the routines. But Sean Ray, Kamal has made a strong case for this year's title.
The thighs are ripped up. You could use a little more sweep on the thighs, but it's in great condition. Held it from yesterday. The music makes you focus on what he's going to be transitioning into next. A little thin in certain areas, but his conditioning is what's got him in this fight here tonight. We have a tendency to see a little better conditioning on the 212 guys. They're not dealing with as much mass to rip up and shred up, but here we're looking at a guy that's done his best with what he has, and it will probably catapult him, I believe, into the top 3 of this competition tonight. Famous Joe Weider pose. Got a very appealing abdominal wall, man. Separation when he hits his abs. The idea in bodybuilding when you're presenting your physique is when you flex the muscle, something's supposed to happen. You want to see some separation. You want to see something detailed and refined. And this is a guy that's bringing that quality, the glutes, the hamstrings, the lower back, and then he comes up to the deltoids. Things start to happen that aren't there when he's relaxed.
Well, and one of the underlying stories here is, as we watch this, knowing that this is Flex Lewis's final competition, is who is going to come out of this show as the man to beat or the contender to win the title next year when the throne is vacated. And Kamal, of course, making a case. We saw some a strong showing from Derek Lunsford. Of course, Ahmad Ashkenani is somebody who we have high hopes for going forward. Hadi Chupan, who is not in this competition, another guy who has shown the ability to push Flex Lewis to the brink. So we have a few guys who have sort of established themselves. So as we watch these guys come out, you know, we can't help but wonder who's going to be that guy going into 2019.
Well, don't let it be lost, Dan, that they're all focusing on the retirement of Flex Lewis. I mean, you can't get beyond that. Next year's looking great. But this guy's setting the tone for us of things to come. And the other bodybuilders are going to have to pay attention to the conditioning factor. This is not a genetically gifted bodybuilder. He's in great shape with some nice body parts. And he's going to take out some guys that are actually genetically more gifted than him because of his
condition. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome from the USA, Derek Lunsford.
Talk about the future of bodybuilding, Dan. Looks like it's starting to arrive right here, right now.
And I'm going to clarify something. I was actually just told that we are only going to have the top five routines here in this 212 division, not the top 10.
That's what they had last year.
Right. So far, we've seen Ahmad Ashkenani, Kamel Argani, and Derek Lunsford make their way to the stage. And Derek Lunsford, of course, one of the real rising stars. You're looking at the 2017 NPC USA overall champion. He made his pro debut last year in Tampa. He won it. A couple months later, after he turned pro, he finished up this division potentially as soon as next year.
Yeah, and you know what? It's just a matter of time. You keep pounding at it. You keep grinding at it. And those muscles, they start to mature. They start to separate. Look at the hamstrings, the glutes, Dan. Those are there. They'll get better with time, like fine wine. That back will start to thicken up a little bit. We'll start to see things a year from now that are not there today. And that will be a vacant title that he'll be chasing one year from this night. And we could be looking at the future of the 212 division right here in front of this young man.
A big thanks to our friends over at Muscle Farm and iHerb.com for helping us present this event so that the entire world can watch it free of charge and take in the action. Those of you guys who weren't able to make the trip here to Vegas, and we encourage you guys to have never been to the Olympia, if you've never been a part of Olympia Weekend, plan it one year and come out here and take it all in. There's nothing like experiencing an Olympia firsthand. It's a tremendous experience. It's inspiring. It's entertaining. And for Derek Lunsford, it was a big weekend as he looks to have landed very much in the top.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the USA, Jose Raymond.
All right, well, here he is, a crowd favorite. If there were a fan's choice in this division, Jose would be right in the mix. A 10th consecutive Olympia appearance. As I mentioned last night, he has competed in the Olympia every year he's been a pro. How about that? A runner-up in 2015. And tonight, as Bob Ciccarello mentioned, competing at the Olympia, or competing, period, actually, for the final time. So, Jose Raymond, we're going to watch your routine, and we salute you, my friend, because you have had yourself a very impressive career.
Very optimistic bodybuilder as well, Dan. This song is appropriate for his farewell routine by Journey, Don't Stop Believing. We got a lot of memories with this kid. Had the pleasure of having him as a guest poser at my show in Baltimore, and having him out in Hawaii as well. Very active in promoting his sport, the body.
Always has a ton of grainy, gnarly muscle. Very much a blue-collar, workman-like approach. He's great with the fans. He's great with the media. He's very well-liked. And I'll tell you what, I'm going to miss covering him, but I know he's going to stick around the sport. This stuff's in his blood. He loves this industry. He loves bodybuilding. He'll always be a bodybuilder. And I've just been proud to cover it and be a part of the ride with him, because Jose Raymond has always treated this sport the way it deserves to be treated. And Jose, we respect you and we appreciate all that you've given this sport. And I know the fans agree as well.
The Boston Mass. You see played Jose better, but at the same time, even when he's off, he's still qualified in a very strong lineup, Dan, to make the finals of this event. Now he's letting us hear the farewell.
All right, there it is. He is spent.
Folks, one more competitor to go. He needs no introduction. He is from the United Kingdom, and he is your six-time 212 Olympia champion, James Flex Lewis.
All right, Dan Solomon, along with Sean Ray, we are watching the number one bodybuilder on the planet, weighing 212 pounds on the nose. They call him the Welsh Dragon. He's won this event each of the last 6 years under the direction of super trainer Neil Hill. He is looking for title number 7. He has told us this will be his final time competing in this division. And as I mentioned, there is no bodybuilder who weighs 212 pounds or less who has had more success than James Flex Lewis. And he is here for what he tells us is going to be the final time in this division.
Talk about a guy that has the true grit. Flex Lewis is unwavering in winning competitions, Dan. He's the first ever Arnold Classic 212 champion, former British champion, and of course, he just killed it on this stage, and in every competition, he's been it.
You know, Sean, I thought last year, managed to win not at his best. There were some problems. He had some issues with his prep in the final weeks. He managed to pull out the victory to keep his run alive. I was concerned for Flex coming into this contest. I wasn't sure how his body was going to respond. I wasn't even sure what the 2018 version of Flex Lewis is. I was concerned based on what we saw last year. There were some trends that I was not comfortable with, but he silenced those concerns right off the bat when he walked out here last night during preliminary judging, and he showed us exactly what he knew he could deliver while some of us doubted he could do it.
Well, you'll notice those big billowing calves, those cow calves, man, they're massive. He's brought the thigh separation back to the stage. And of course, from the back, this is where has a tendency to separate himself from the pack. His peers have not gotten up to the thickness that he's got on his back, the delts, the tightness in the glutes.
And to be clear, one of the reasons Flex and his trainer Neil have suggested they're going to walk from this division is they feel like the division is now holding them back. He feels like his body wants to do more than what this division will allow. The idea of having to make weight has held him back, has limited some of his progress. So perhaps we'll get to see him in open competition in the years to come. I know he has some business interests, things that he wants to focus on. He's growing a family. He and his wife, Allie, have a beautiful little girl, and they have plans potentially to grow their family. So not only does he want to grow his physique, but he also wants to grow his family. And Sean Ray, this is not only one of the most popular champions, but he's one of the most admirable, noble, and fan-friendly champions this sport has ever known.
He's not done. I guarantee you we're going to see him go for an open division competition.